continue.
So last time we explained A'azam Surah, the greatest chapter in the Quran. Do you remember what that was? Chapter Al-Ikhlas. The Prophet ﷺ said it's the one-third of the Quran. Today, the Shaykh in his sequence starts with the greatest verse in the Quran. So he's now using, I mean, after he put the rules of how we understand the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he now starts getting the quotes or the verses from the Quran and Hadith to support his argument, to support the understanding of Ahl Sunnah and Jama'ah. Last time we explained قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ وَحَدَ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. Today he starts with the greatest verse in the Quran, which is the verse of Ayat Al-Kursi. Do we all know the Ayat Al-Kursi? Yeah. So, and he basically says, we describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but what he described himself in the verse of Al-Kursi. No. Ayat Al-Kursi starts by what? Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum la atakhuduhu sinatun wa la nawm lahu ma fi al-samawati wa ma fi al-ard man da ladhi yashfa'u indahu illa bi-idhnih ya'lamu ma bayna aydihim wa ma khalfahum wa la yuhituna bi shay'in min ilmihi illa bima sha'a wasi'a kursiyuhu al-samawati wa al-ard وَلَا يَؤُدُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. Today's lectures, basically we are going to explain this verse. Before we go into explaining the names of Allah and the attributes on this greatest verse of the Quran, we will talk about the importance of this verse. Now, as Muslims, how many times we recite Ayatul Kursi daily? Once? Why once? In the Ahadith of the Sunnah, you recite it when you go to sleep, in the sunset and the sunrise, and after every prayer. This is the Sunnah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So if you fulfill the Sunnah in your life as a Muslim, you will recite Ayatul Kursi 8 times per day. And you can imagine the reward of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala for you, for each letter. The words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to you. I did not count the letters of the verse, but there are so many. So, we recite the verse of the Al-Kursi 8 times, maybe more. Why we recite it? We will tell maybe some of the hadith. Do we know the story of Abu Huraira and the Shaytan? Do you know that story? So, the Shaytan came as a human being, and he came to Abu Huraira. Abu Huraira was responsible for some of the zakah things and that he was disputing and so forth. And he tried to steal from him the first day, and the second day, and the third day. Every time Abu Huraira will quote him. In the end, in the last time, Abu Huraira said, I will take you to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He said, leave me alone, I will teach you something. Don't sleep till you recite Ayatul Kursi. And Allah will preserve you. مَا يَزَلُ عَلَيْكِ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَافِظْ حَتَّى تُصْبِحْ وَلَا يَقْرَبُكَ الشَّيْطَانِ. Allah will preserve you when you sleep if you recite this verse, and the shaitan will not come to you. So when Abu Huraira on the second day, he told the Prophet ﷺ what happened with him. Prophet ﷺ said the word that we used so many, his صدقك وهو كذوب. In teaching you, he was truthful, but he was a liar because he was a thief. Okay? So we learn from this that when we sleep, we recite the verse of Al-Kursi, that Allah will preserve us, will حافظ, okay, protect us, maybe, is a better word. So in the other hadith, which is hadith Abi Umama, the hadith says, "Man qara ayat al-kursi dubra kulli salah." Who recites this verse of al-kursi after each prayer, nothing will prevent him going to paradise except if he dies after that. See how much is it good? How good is this verse? we will understand why it's so powerful, so great this verse is, because the value it has. This verse has five big names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, Al-Hayy, Al-Qayyum, Al-Ali, Al-Azim. These are one of the greatest names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That in the hadith Umama radiallahu anha said, none of these names, if you ask Allah by these names, Allah will reward you, will answer you, will respond to you. That's why the verse is very great. It is a great verse that we need to teach our kids. We implement it in our life and recite it when we go to bed. After each prayer, we recite it and so forth. So because it has great rewards. That's to start with. Now, one of the questions that from this verse, of this introduction, we realize that the Quran, even though it's the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but there are some verses more important than the others, right? If you can look at it, even the Shaykh, he put these verses in sequence, in importance. So there are some verses of the Quran has more effect, more value, I would say. Ayatul Kursi, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ. That's why we, last time we said, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ تَعْدِلُ ثُلْثُ الْقُرْآنِ. It's as if you read one third of the Quran. Not literally, but in terms of reward. Why? Because we said the Quran has three main components. One of them is Tawheed. لا إله إلا الله رسول الله. If you read the Quran, Allah is emphasizing this meaning of Tawheed. And the second one is the rules. Salah, Siyam, Nikah, so forth. The third one is what? The stories of the previous prophets and nations. These are the main three components of the Quran. But even with that, reading a story or when you, the most important thing in Islam is what? The Tawheed, the Aqeedah. Because this is your fundamental thing. If you lose the Aqeedah, that means even if you pray, if you pay charity, you do fasting, it might go haba'an manthura, in vain. It has no value. Just like an un-Muslim who donates money and helps the poor, Allah might reward him in this dunya for what he does by good reputation and whatever. We give him a gift or whatever. But in the hereafter, because he's mushrik, his work doesn't have any value. In front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَيْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءَ. There's no sin bigger than shirk. Okay? So, that means the Quran has some verses more important. Actually had even more effect when you recite a verse about death. It's scary. It's not like you recite something about تَبَّتْ يَدَا أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبْ. When Allah subhanahu says, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ, it shocks you that one day all of us will die. You remember that my destiny is coming. Every day we are getting closer and closer to that day that we face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why, again, the Quran, even though it's the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but some of it is more important than the other. So it's not a big issue for us, but we will go back to the verse of the halaqa is explaining the Ayatul Kursi. And again, I emphasize that Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah brought this verse to support that we only or Ahl Sunnah affirm what Allah affirms for Himself. Now, the verse says what? Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum. Allah starts by the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatest name. Allahu la ilaha illa hu al-hayy al-qayyum. As if you are making shahada. Actually, there are three verses in the Quran that this have this word, al-hayy al-qayyum. وَعَنَتِ الْوُجُوهُ لِلْحَيِّ الْقَيُّومِ. And this verse, and alif lam mim, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum, in the beginning of chapter Al-Imran. These three verses, that the Prophet said, if you ask Allah by these names, Allah will reward you. Now, Allahu la ilaha illallah, as if you're saying La ilaha illallah Rasulullah, it's just the shahada. When you say that, we said Allahu la ilaha illahu, it means what? There is no one worth to be worshipped except Allah. That's what it means. That's what it means. Al-Hayy al-Qayyum. Now, we're coming to the names of Allah. Al-Hayy al-Qayyum, what does it mean? Do you know what Al-Hayy means? Ever living, he does not die. He was there before and after. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We as human beings, we are living right now, but we will die, we will be nothing. We were Adam, we were nothing several years ago. But we cannot say this about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Us, we were nothing. 50, 40, 50, 20 years ago, some of us were not even available in this dunya. And then after 50 years or maybe 100 years, whatever, who can live more? Or may Allah give him more age or whatever, life. We will be nothing again as humans. And although we are sharing the same name, Al-Hayy, we are Hayya now, we are living. But we cannot compare our life, our ever living like our life to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the Hayy, the one who is always there. Al-Qayyum, what Al-Qayyum means? This is a very powerful word actually in Arabic. When you say Al-Qayyum, is the one who is mudabbir, the one who has in control, and he is independent. You need him, he doesn't need you. Okay? He is أَفَمَنْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ نَفْسٍ. Imagine this. Allah is in control of every nafs. This is the verse of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in control of this universe. Whatever happens, whatever going on in this universe. So what Al-Qayyum is the verse قائم. Meaning قائم, he's standing on it. In control. مدبر. Everything is in his universe. Nothing happens without his permission. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. Now, لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. What does it mean? Do we all know آية الكرسي? لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. It means what? Allah does not sleep. Does not even feeling sleep. But we cannot afford not sleep. وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ وَجَعَلْنَا النَّوْمَ لِبَاسَ وَسُبَاتَ. Means you have to sleep, you have to rest as a human being. So, being not able to sleep, I mean, if you don't sleep, sleeping itself is a tribute of weakness. That's why we cannot say this about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say or negating this attribute. He does not sleep. He's always alive. But the human beings, they get sleep, they are get tired and so forth. Not like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even though sometimes we are awake also. We're trying to differentiate between the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the attributes of the human beings. Sometimes we share the same name, but the how, the kaifa, the tashbih, resemblance or likeness are not there. We are not equal. We are not equal. أَفَمَنْ يَخْلُقْ كَمَنْ لَا يَخْلُقْ. No, the one who is a creator is not like his creation. We are different. That's what we are trying to emphasize in the meaning for this Aqeedah Wasatiyyah. What the Shaykh is trying to say. The name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his attribute, he does not sleep. He does not feel asleep like human. Allah says in the Quran, وَهُوَ يُطْعِمُ وَلَا يُطْعَمُ. He provides food for his creation, but he does not eat. You see, we need to feed ourselves, otherwise we will die. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not like this, because he's sustainer, he is in control. We need him, he is the ghani. We are the one who go after, we are the fuqara, we are the poor. We have the defects, but he's perfect, he's complete. Okay? لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. These two, I forgot to mention that when we say Al-Hayy Al-Qayyum, actually, I just want to go back to this meaning, is that you have in control sovereignty, and control or and complete and perfect description or attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he's high and he's capable, he's in control. That's what it means. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنَامُ وَلَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ أَنْ يَنَامُ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith Abu Musa, that Allah does not sleep, nor he should sleep. If I can explain this the way, translate this this way. But as again, the attribute of sleeping is a defect. Okay? And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum, la ta'akhudhu sinatun wa la nawm. Lahu ma fi as-samawati wa ma fi al-ard. Everything now, the mulk, whatever's in the universe is in hands and control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he's what? He's the hayy al-qayyum. The one who controls this great universe is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the hayy al-qayyum. He knows everything. طيب من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه. Now شفاعة is a concept. Do you know what شفاعة means? Interceding or intercession. In the Quran it's mentioned several places. Now the شفاعة interceding in our religion as Muslims, there is no middle layer. In other religions you might find a religious guy in between the people and the God. We do not have this middle person. Even the prophets of Allah, they are not middle people. The prophets and the messengers of Allah are guiders. They guide us to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we cannot worship them or meet them, make them a middle or shafi'. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except with some conditions. And this is where the ayah says, لا يشفع إلا بإذنه. من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه. He has to give approval for shafa'a or intercession. Intercession, it's part of our aqeedah. We will come to this actually in more details in the aqeedah itself. We will come to this later. But intercession is mentioned in several ahadith. And it will happen in the day of judgment. And the biggest shafa'a is the shafa'a of the Prophet ﷺ for the believers and the wrongdoers who will be tortured, and by the shafa'a of the Prophet ﷺ they will come out of the hellfire. Okay? And we know that the Prophet ﷺ is the one that also makes shafa'a for the people to enter Jannah. Because nobody will enter till the Prophet ﷺ, Muhammad, they open the door for him. The khazin or the guard of the doors of Jannah is commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to open the Jannah doors except first for Muhammad ﷺ. And the day of judgment, the Prophet ﷺ will supplicate for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell him to rise your head and ask, I will respond to your question or supplication. And he makes the shafa'a, which is what we call al-maqam al-mahmood, as the Quran says. Okay? من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم. Now the shafa'a in the Quran, وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنْ اِرْتَضَى. So there is then another condition that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when somebody wants to make shafa'a, Allah should, says in the Quran that the shafa'a is with his permission. This is one condition. The second condition is that Allah is pleased with the one who intercedes and the one who will be receiving the shafa'a, as the Quran says. Okay? من الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم. Allah سبحانه وتعالى knows what's before and what's after, what's in the past, what's in the future. What this is what the means of the verse. يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء. They are not able to encounter all the knowledge of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Nobody, because Allah سبحانه وتعالى he is the عالم. He knows what's before and what's after. We might have some knowledge, we might have some ilm, but that ilm is not like the ilm of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That ilm is not like the ilm of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what we know. Okay. طيب. طيب the علم of Allah سبحانه وتعالى ولا يحيطون بعلمه. What knowledge we are talking about here? علم, what happens and what happened before and what happens after, and also the علم of Allah himself, his attributes. We don't know. It's part of the علم that we need to understand and we need to learn, but we learn only from the book of Allah and the Sunnah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and we stop there, because till the day of judgment, we will not know much, because that's why we are affirming what Allah affirms for himself and negating what Allah negates for himself. Because we cannot measure things the way we measured it in this dunya. If Allah Ali Alim, Allah is Alim. Allah is Hay, Allah is Hay. Allah is Sami, Allah is Sami. But how is it like my our Sama'? It's important that we do not resemble things. We are not equal. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Okay. وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض. Now, this is كرسي. Now is mentioned in this verse. الكرسي, as Ibn Abbas said, it's the place of the foot of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. It's the place of the foot of the Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And the al-kursi is under the throne. And the kursi compared to the throne, as if like a ring thrown in the desert. You now can imagine how big is al-kursi and how big is the throne, and how big is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is on top of the throne. When we say Allahu Akbar, when we say Allahu Akbar, it's Allahu Akbar. Yani if you compare the kursi to the heavens, the seventh heavens and seventh earth, the kursi is bigger. The chair is bigger. And if you compare the kursi, which is bigger than all these seven heavens and seven earths, is it just like if you, it is like as if it's like a ring thrown in the desert compared to the throne? You can imagine how big is it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu in top of the throne, al-arsh. And you can imagine we have this universe, and the chair of Allah is bigger than all these what we see around us. That's what Ibn Abbas says. And this hadith is Hassan. So you can imagine when we say Allahu Akbar is Allahu Akbar. And Allah is bigger than anything you can imagine. When you say the universe, that the light travels millions of years of light to reach us. And this is, we are still in this this universe, and maybe in the first heaven, and we are talking about seven of these, and the chair is bigger than all these together with the seven earths, and the throne is bigger than that, and the comparison is huge. And then you can imagine how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how big is Him, how Allahu Akbar. Okay? وَسِعَ كُرُسِيهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمْ. See, look how things are attached to it. وَسِعَ كُرُسِيهُ. وَسِعَ, the word وَسِعَ means is widened, is encountered or holds. I don't know how to explain this word. وَسِعَ كُرُسِيهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Kursi is bigger than all this. وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَ. What يَؤُودُهُ means? He does not get tired. It's not heavy for him. It's even heavy for us even to imagine. وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَ وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. Now, وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا. Preserving this universe, preserving the chair, preserving this huge things that Allah is talking about, it's nothing for Him. وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. علو means He's on top of everything. He's high. And He is the greatest, العظيم. That's why this verse is so great. It has the five big names: Al-Azim, Al-Hayy, Al-Qayyum, Allah, and Al-Ali, and what else? Allah, Al-Hayy, Al-Qayyum, Al-Azim, Al-Ali. They are big names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they have also, I keep reminding you with this, Allah's names have their attributes attached. You cannot separate the meaning of the name as an attribute. It's an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we say this name is Ahmed, you know what Ahmed means in Arabic, or Muhammad? Muhammad means that the one the people are pleased with and they thank him for his work or any he thinks he does. When we say his name is Abdullah, he is the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what it means, his name is. But he could be kafir, and his name is Abdullah. But when it comes to Allah's name, when Allah says Alim, He's the Alim, He's the Hay, He's everlasting, ever life. So the description or the attribute is part of His name. It's part of His name. The meaning of the name stays. We do not separate the meaning of the name from the name itself. Okay? ولا يعوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. And in this also, we have five names, but we also have so many attributes in this verse. Can you tell me what some attributes that we mentioned? He does not sleep, does not get sleepy. عليم, واسع. So many things in this verse. So this is what I have in my mind, I mean, today for is explaining the Ayatul Kursi, which is a very important verse. And again, I reaffirm that the Shaykh al-Islam started by قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, then the verse of the Kursi, and then he will continue bringing verses from the Quran to affirm the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَعُودُهُ. There's one thing maybe I will say, because some groups, maybe you have, you know, just to help you actually understand some deviations, some groups, when they said about al-'ulum, some of them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is alu, but He's also among us. He's dissolved on us. Which is logically, it's not acceptable. But also they use some of the verses in the Quran to support their argument. They use the verse in the Quran, مَا يَكُونُ مِن نَجْوَى ثَلَاثَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ رَابِعُهُ. Allah is with three or four people together. He's the. If they are three, Allah is fourth. If they are five, they are Allah is the sixth one. And in the other verse, which is Surah Al-Hadid, Allah says, وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. Allah is with you wherever you go. Now, the meaning here doesn't mean that He's personally with you, but by His knowledge, because He knows what you're doing, because He's the Hayy Qayyum we're talking about. He knows what you were doing. You are under the surveillance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where are you going to go? Allah knows what you're doing. It doesn't mean that He's dissolved in His creation or He's on that side or that side. No. Allah, Al-Aliyyu Al-Azim, stays there on top. Now, a question. We'll come to this later also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every night, in the third of the night, Allah descends to the first heaven. And there's no conflict with this. Allah descends, saying for people, who is making istighfar, I will give him maghfirah. Allah yanzil. This is another attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will descend to the first heaven, as the authentic hadith comes. There is no conflict between this and that. Allah is always Ali. Ali by His hikmah, by His qudra, by His everything, by His knowledge, by His presence, He's there. Himself is there. But if He descends for a while and comes back, it's Allah's action. When the Prophet described Him that He descends, that means He descends. We accept. But how, we don't know. This is the problem. We don't know how. But the Prophet told us that He descends and even talk, is there any mustaghfir, I will give him maghfir. And every night this happens. We don't know, but this is, we'll come to it inshallah. Okay? Wa jazakumullah khair. If you have any question, inshallah, we'll try to answer it.